I have found the light of the blueprint interface, and soon you will too. Never will you have to use those cursed castings ever again. This will make your old sloppy code not only 100 times more readable, but also significantly faster on contemporary hardware. You might be asking, what is this blueprint interface that you're raving about? Well, a blueprint interface is nothing more than a collection of definitions that your blueprints can use. They lack any definition other than the inputs and outputs. They allow any blueprint that interfaces with them to call an event that runs on all other implementations of the function. With that said, let me show you the light of the interface. One last thing, before we begin, the project I will be using is linked in the description, though it is not strictly needed to follow along. I will also be in level 1 in this level 1 level. To get started, we need to create an interface. To do that, we should go to the folder named Blueprints, then Interfaces. Next, we can right-click in the content browser, then hover over Blueprints, Blueprint Interface. Finally, give it a name and hit Enter. Now, we can double-click to open it. When we do so, we will see the normal blueprint editor with one major difference. This blueprint is considered read-only. That is because a blueprint interface does not and cannot have any code. It just holds the event inputs and outputs. Other major differences with an interface is that they cannot add new variables, edit graphs, or add components. To start, we will rename the function named new function underscore zero to pickup. Then we will add a generic object reference and we will call it pickup object. Next, we hit compile and save. Now that we have created the interface, we need to add it to the actors we wish to use it on. For this example, it will be our first person character, found in content, import, first person BP, blueprints. Then open the first person character and go to the event graph. Next, to add the interface to the blueprint, we need to go to class settings. Then under interfaces, click add and search for the interface. Then you will see it under pickup. Now we need to hit compile to be able to use the interface. Next, we will do the same thing for the object we wish to pick up. It can be found in content, blueprints, fragment, and it will be called soul shard pickup. Open it. Then do the same thing as last time. Class settings, add, pickup, compile, and save. Now that the actors know about our interface, we can implement it. First, in the character controller, we can right-click pickup and select implement event. We can then replace the custom event, soul fragment pickup, with pickup. Then from pickup object, we will add an equal equals block and set the second value to soul guard pickup. Then we will add a branch. Connect these up. And the true will go into our old code. I'll just make this look pretty. This allows us to call the pickup function on any object just by testing for what we picked up, saving us from making hundreds of custom events for each pickup object. Now, in the soul shard pickup class, we need to remove the cast node and the custom event node. Next, we drag from other actor and select pickup message. Then, for pickup object, search for soul shard pickup. Finally, reconnect the destroy actor node to the pickup message. Now, compile everything and test if it worked by running down the hall into a fragment. It should increase the number in the top left by 1, and the fragment should disappear. Now that's working. Interfaces with outputs. Now that we have the basics of interfaces, we can move on to more complex ones. We'll now make a new function in our pickup interface and call it print object. Next, add an input of an object reference and name it object. Then, add an output of type string and name it name. Next, press compile and save. Then we can go back to the first person character and double click on print object. Here we can define the local definition of this function. We will do that by dragging from the object and selecting get object name. Then drag the output to the output. That allows us to drag it out in the event graph and connect it to the execute path of the pickup function in the first person character. I'll do that before the branch. Then, for object, we can use the pickup object. Finally, with the output of this function, we can drag that into a print string in order to print the name of the object that we picked up. Compile and save. And then last, we can test it the same way we did with the other interface test by running down here and picking these up. And you see up in that top right where it says soul shard pickup? That's coming from our Blueprint interface. Hopefully, Blueprint interfaces are not so scary anymore. If you want any other help into how to use UE5, a playlist of all my UE5 videos should be showing up. And if you could, please don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell for more weekly UE5 content. Have a great day, and bye for now.